Ever wonder how to encrypt your files with just a few lines of Python? In this video, we're building a simple but powerful file encryption app using Fernet from the cryptography module. You'll be able to lock and unlock any file with ease, perfect for sensitive data, backups. I'm going to give you a quick example how this works before we hop into the building. So here I have all my secrets. Don't look, I need to encrypt this. We can encrypt our file. And you'll notice that it looks like a whole bunch of mumbo jumbo now. Nobody can understand what that is. And we'll also be able to decrypt the files. If we go ahead and run this again, we go to our example, you can see my secrets again, but don't look, please. So if this sounds like something you're interested in building, we'll go ahead and hop into the guide in just a second. Before we do, I want to talk about the supported file types, and you can see them on the screen here if you want to take a second to pause. So we can do notes, plain text files, image files work fine. But unlike when we saw the mumbo jumbo of our notes, they actually won't be able to be opened while encrypted. Things like PDF, docs, XLS can be decrypted. Corruption can occur if they're edited while encrypted, so be very careful with those. MP3, MP4, zip, same thing there. And any of our files like Python, source code, but make sure you don't run them while encrypted. You want to keep all those files within their same folder. So before you ruin any files, make sure you're following along properly. You're checking the code and listening for the notes that I make along the way. While we rebuild this project, I'll also make sure to add some important comments. So with that being said, let's go ahead and learn how we can encrypt our files. Okay, so I'm going to start off by, instead of making a new file, I'm going to make a new folder. I'm going to create this on my desktop. Create a new folder, and we'll give it a name. I'll call this one Fernet Example. Go ahead and create that. Open the folder. We're going to be using quite a few different files today, so keeping them all in one place is a great idea. We can go ahead and create a new file, and we can call this one Encryption, or maybe encryptor.py, whatever you'd like. And this is where we're going to be managing the logic in order to encrypt those files. And before we start coding, before we get started, we do need to do an install for cryptography, which is a required library. So pip or pip3 install cryptography cryptography. Go ahead and run that. Might take a second to install, but once that's installed, you should be good to go. I realize I made a spelling mistake in my encryptor. We're going to rename this before it bothers me. Okay, so for our install, we're going to do from cryptography. Dot Fernet. We're going to import capital F Fernet. So this will allow us to have file encryption and decryption using Fernet, which is a symmetric encryption system. The goal for this script, it'll allow us to encrypt and decrypt files using a secret key. We can generate a new key, load it, and then use it to secure our files. Let's first handle the function of creating a new key. This will be our secret. Only we can encrypt and decrypt those specific files. So we'll create a function with our def keyword, and let's call this one write underscore key. Don't need anything within the parameters. We'll first establish a key, which will have equal capital F Fernet, and we can use the dot generate underscore key built-in function to generate that new key within Fernet. And then we'll go ahead and say with open, and we can go ahead and create the key. Within the brackets, we can include a name within the string value. I'm going to call mine secret.key. After the string, we're going to add a comma, add another string, and we'll do WB. Inside the brackets, we'll say as, and we'll reference this as our key underscore file. So this will open the secret key, and we're using the WB for write binary mode. We'll go to the next line, which should be indented one over, and we'll have our key underscore file dot write to that key value we've established before. This will essentially save to the key file. And if it doesn't exist, it will create one for us. So let's go ahead and create that key. We'll get out of this function. We'll move all the way back to the left, call upon our write underscore key with the empty brackets. Let's run our code. And we can see our secret.key appears in the left side. If we click on it, we actually have a unique key. So we're going to be using this key in order to encrypt and decrypt. I would recommend also making a backup of this key somewhere on your computer. Even if you wanted to, you know, make a new file and, you know, backup.txt, copying, pasting, maybe saving this to your documents, because if you lose this key, you will not be able to encrypt or decrypt your files. So please make a backup. Also, after calling this function, go ahead and comment it off. We want to comment it off because we don't want to keep generating the keys. If we keep generating new keys and we don't have a backup, we won't be able to unencrypt our files, right? So think of it when we encrypt a file, we then have a key, and only that key can unlock that file. If we were to replace the key and we're trying to use a new key to open it up, we're not gonna have the best results. But please comment this off so you're not generating a new key every single time. And I'm gonna put a little note here, uncomment to generate a new key. Now we'll create a function to load the existing secret key from a file. So we can call this one load key. We're gonna go ahead and return and then open and look for our secret dot key. And this time, instead of the WB, we're going to be using the RB. Inside the brackets, we're going to do dot read. This will read and return the key in binary mode. So WB, write binary, RB, read binary. So now that we have our key sorted out, let's go ahead and create a function to encrypt the file. And ahead of time, let's make a new file in our project. We'll call this one secrets, or whatever you'd like. And we'll just do a TXT, but I showed you the files that could be encrypted before. We'll just put some text here for now. Okay, back in our encryptor, let's create that function to encrypt underscore file. And within the brackets, we're going to be wanting to grab the file name. So we'll pass that along in our project. We'll then want to establish a key, which will be our load underscore key function. And this will load the encryption key. And then we'll establish Fernet, which will equal capital F Fernet, and we're going to be using that key. Essentially, this line creates a Fernet object with the key. Okay, so now we're going to want to open the file to encrypt in binary read mode. So say with open, look at that file name. We're going to have the RB again, reading binary as file, and you'll notice a common theme from up here. And this time we're going to be storing the original data. So we can just call it original data, which will equal the file.read with the empty brackets. This will read the original file contents. Still within this function, but we're going to go back one indent. We're going to reference our now encrypted data, and this will equal the fernet.encrypt. Then we're going to pass through that original data. So this essentially handles our encryption of the file contents. We have the key, we create the fernet object with the key, we read the data, and we say, okay, this is now being stored as original data. And then we say, all right, I'm going to encrypt it. What am I encrypting? Well, that original data. After that, we're going to need to open the same file in binary write and overwrite it with the encrypted data. So we can do our with open. And actually, you know, we can save a little bit of time here. Go ahead and copy and paste this. And instead of RB, we're going to do WB. And for the file, we're going to do the file.write. And within the brackets, we'll include the encrypted data. So it's going to essentially rewrite the file with that encrypted data. Okay, let's go ahead and try this out. We're going to pass through the secrets.txt. Make sure the capitalization, spelling, and everything is exact. You can even copy and paste it from here if you'd like. We'll save and run our program. And look at that. Our secrets.txt is fully encoded. You can open it up with TextEdit or Notepad. I can see that it is no longer the hello secrets or whatever we had had. How can we get it back? Well, we're going to need to decrypt the file. Now, I would recommend commenting off the encryption function after it's been encrypted. We'll say uncomment to encrypt. So let's go ahead and create our function to decrypt. And you know what? We can save a lot of time here. I'm going to copy and paste our encrypt. Instead of encrypt, we'll say decrypt. And we'll open up the file name. Great. And we'll want to leave this as read binary instead of the original data. We're going to be looking at the encrypted data. Then we'll want to find the decrypted data. And instead of the encrypt, we'll decrypt. And we won't want to look at the original data. We want to look at the encrypted data. And we'll also write, instead of the encrypted data, the decrypted data. I know we just made some changes, but let's talk about this function a little bit. So we load the key. We then create the Fernet object with the key. We open the file to decrypt in binary with our RB or read binary mode. We then read the encrypted data. We decrypt the data using Fernet. We then open the file again, this time in write binary mode with our WB. and then we overwrite it with the decrypted contents. Now, if we have the incorrect key, so if you lost your key, if you wrote to the key again and it's different from what you started, you will get an error saying, hey, this is the invalid key, I cannot decrypt this. But because we've commented off smartly and even backed up our key in case of catastrophic failure, let's go ahead and see how our decryption works. We can see our mumbo jumbo, go to our decrypt file and pass through our secrets.txt, save and run. Hello Secrets is back. There we go. And just like that, you've now got a working file encryption app in Python. Try it out with different files, integrate it into your own tools, or even build a GUI for it. Smash the like button if this helped, and subscribe for more Python projects like this one. I'll put the sample code from my GitHub pages in the description below, but please be careful. I don't want anyone to be like, you encrypted my files and now I can't access it. Use this code with caution and with care. Create backups of the files, create backups of the keys, etc., etc. You don't want to bork any important files. So even here, I'm going to do the uncomment to decrypt. Otherwise, have a great day, dream big, code bigger, and we'll see you in the next one.